whispers in the morning.
Because the rule says don't dissociate anything apart from the electrolyte, that is those ones in aqueous solution, dissociated ions in water. So this is, I've expanded this molecular equation into the constituent what? Ions. So what do I do next? I find species that are found on the left hand side and also on the right hand side, circle them and cancel them out. First, I have hydrogen ion here. This is hydrogen ion. Check, do we have any other hydrogen ion here? No, which means this one stands. I'll bring it down, I won't cancel it. Second one is SO42 minus. This is it. Check if you have it here. Yes. Look at the SO42 minus. Look at it. And there are only one. So what do I do? I strike it out. It's no more there. Then the next one is two.
Nice to see you, a good fellow and a good follower like you.
Today, I'm going to teach you how to write and balance ionic equations. How to balance and write also ionic equations. First, you should know what ionic equation is and be able to differentiate it from molecular equations. Ionic equation is actually representing the particles participating in a reaction, or representing the molecules participating in a reaction in form of dissociated ions in aqueous solution. So when we talk about ionic equations, they have to do with electrolytes mainly. So instead of writing the molecular formula, the compounds are written in form of dissociated ions. The cations and the anions that makes up that compound is written together with the magnitude of the charges. The one that is negatively charged is indicated. The one that is positively charged is indicated. So the ionic equation will help you to know whether the type of reaction, because when we talk about displacement reaction, you discover that from your ionic equation, you can know which one has displaced the other. Then, ionic equation will prove to you that there are reactions that you think they are different. There are reactions that may have different reactants, but at the end, the overall ionic equation will prove that they are the same type of reaction. Like every neutralization reaction, that is, reaction between an acid and a base, have the same ionic equations. So, but writing the molecules, writing the formula, like I taught you in balancing chemical equation, what you have there is called molecular equations. So the common equations we use in chemistry are actually molecular equations. But today, I'm going to teach you how to write ionic equations. But before then, I'm happy you can distinguish between ionic equation and molecular equations. So molecular equation is writing the molecular formula without putting any charge, but ionic equation is writing the participating molecules or the compounds in form of dissociated ions in aqueous solutions. That is, you can only dissociate the electrolytes. Now, let me give you the rules. Rules, these rules are very, very important in writing ionic equations. You see them, as I say them there on the screen. Number one is that you don't dissociate solids. This is where state of matter of the reactants and products matters a lot. Don't anything that is in solid, that is S, in bracket S, don't dissociate it. Don't dissociate gases or volatile substances. Non-electrolytes should not be dissociated. I repeat, don't dissociate solids. Don't dissociate gases or volatile components of the chemical reaction. Then secondly, make sure that you know the charges present on each ion, whether it's a compound ion or a singly charged ion, a kind of, if you are talking about, when I say compound ion, you know, if you write Na plus, this is just one element. But if you collectively write this, you know that SO4 should have a charge of minus 2. So indicate the charges present on each radical or on each atom. Then, number two, when you dissociate those ones that should be dissociated and they are only the aqueous parts of the equation, the ones that are dissolved in water, when we say aqueous solutions, they are solutions in which water is the solvent. So anything that is not soluble is not participating in ionic equation. So if you meet anything that is solid, repeat it that way, because it do not dissociate. It doesn't dissolve in water. Since it doesn't dissolve in water, we don't assume that it dissociates at all. Then, if you see gases, repeat that same gas. But when you see sodium chloride, for example, NaCl, aqueous. For you to, if you want to represent it in ionic equation, you write it Na plus Cl minus. That is their charges. Instead of writing the sodium chloride, you now write it Na plus Cl minus. That is it. Then, another step that is needed in writing ionic equation is that after expanding the molecules into their ions, so after dissociating the molecules into their ions, cancel ions that are similar and equal in number. Cancel them out. Meaning, in writing ionic equation, in the product, in the reactant side, if I have Cl minus, and I'll come to the product side after dissociation, I'll also have another Cl minus. I'll just cancel because they are similar. So cancel similar ions that are equal in number. Then, as you are dissociating the molecules into ions, also obey the number of atoms present. Meaning, if I have 2NaCl, if you are going to dissociate it, you still write 2Na plus plus 2Cl minus. These two will not be forgotten. If I have H2SO4, writing it in form of ion, dissociating it will now tell me this hydrogen is 2. I'll put that to H plus, then plus SO42 minus. So as you are dissociating the molecules into ions, also don't forget to repeat the actual number of the atoms present. Lest I forget, why dissociate? Don't dissociate water or hydrogen peroxide also. Water should not be dissociated. Just like I said in the rule number one, solids, gases, water, and hydrogen peroxide should not be dissociated. Just repeat them exactly the way they are written. I think with these rules, let's start applying them because speaking is not the major thing. Let's go down into the action. Don't fear writing ionic equations. They are very, very simple. By doing it now, you get used to them. Okay, let's see a neutralization reaction between H2SO4 plus sodium hydroxide to give us a salt, which is sodium tetrahydrosulfate 6 plus water. Then, let us take a look at another neutralization. Although, let me follow this one first. Remember, you have to balance this equation to help you write the ions well. Sodium is 2 here, but 1, so I will put 2 here. And this state of matter is very necessary. This is aqueous. This is aqueous. This is aqueous. And this is liquid. I told you, only those in aqueous state should be dissociated. Anything apart from aqueous should not be dissociated. That's why water will not be dissociated. Now, checking this hydrogen now is 2. But here, it is still 2. So total from the reactant side is 4. So when we come here, we need to adjust such that what hydrogen becomes now 4. With this, I'm sure the equation is balanced. Oxygen here is 4 plus 2, which is 6. Then oxygen here is 4 plus 2 times 1, which is still 6. Now, ionic equation. This is the molecular equation. Over here is the molecular equation. Now, let me get to the ionic equation. Now, this is the first one and is in aqueous. What do I do? Hydrogen is 2 and hydrogen is plus 1. That is the charge on hydrogen. Know it today. Hydrogen has plus 1. Hydrogen has plus 1. You can use this acronym NAC. NAC. All these ones, sodium, hydrogen, potassium, all of them have plus 1. But you can use CAMG, meaning calcium, magnesium. You can just say, tell a friend, be calm, or something like that. Beryllium, calcium, magnesium are all plus 2. Then, aluminium is plus 3. Oxygen is minus 2. So, just use NAC and be calm. Just when you say be calm, you put a G. Remember, this is beryllium, this is calcium, this is magnesium, they are all plus 2. Oxygen is minus 2. Button? Yes.
What about
barium? Barium is also there. Those group 2, all the group 2 elements have plus 2. All the group 2 elements, the barium, also have plus 2. Be majestic and scales be rare. You must cover the whole group 2, even strontium. All of them have plus 2. But these are the common ones, the common compounds we come across. But barium and barium, that's barium and beryllium, all have plus 2. Now, let's go. I said, back to writing the ionic equation, here I have 2, then I say 2H plus, because this is NAC, sodium, hydrogen, potassium, all have plus 1. That's why I wrote this plus 1 here. Then, plus SO4, 2 minus. SO4 2 minus, SO3, 2 minus, note them, then CO3, all of them are 2 minus, as the charge is present. Then another fact, all these ones are all having minus 2. Then, if you come to anything like this, remember they don't, these ones are a form of ion, something must be attached. NO3 minus. Then, SO for I've mentioned that one. So NO3 minus, these are the things, common ones we come across with the common anions. Then chlorine is minus 1, of course. Then, SO4, 2 minus, then plus, I write this 2. 2Na plus, remember sodium is part of those ones that have only plus 1. Then OH as a group, OH as a group have minus 1. So this one, all have minus 1. These three all have minus 1, while this one all have minus 2. So NCO. Then OH should now be plus OH minus, that's hydroxyl ion, to give me. Here, I repeat, 2Na plus, plus, here is my SO4. What we say SO4 have? 2 minus. Then, plus, don't write H plus, because this is water. Just repeat it, 2H2O. Because the rule says, don't dissociate anything apart from the electrolyte. That is, those ones in aqueous solution, dissociated ions in water. So, this is, I've expanded this molecular equation into the constituent words, ions. So what do I do next? I find species that are found on the left-hand side and also on the right-hand side, circle them and cancel them out. First, I have hydrogen ion here. This is hydrogen ion. Check, do we have any other hydrogen ion here? No, which means this one stands. I'll bring it down. I won't cancel it. Second one is SO42 minus. This is it. Check if you have it here. Yes. Look at the SO42 minus. Look at it. And there are only one. So what do I do? I strike it out. It's no more there. Then the next one is 2Na plus. Check 2Na plus here. We have it. 2Na plus, 2Na plus. There you go. So this is OH on the reactant side. Do I have any OH here? No. So which means this one survives plus OH minus. To give me now, the only thing remaining now is 2H2O. So this is the ionic equation of this molecular equation. This is the final ionic equation. Then, if you like, you can still, lest I forget, there are these two here, yes. These two govern both sodium and OH, so which means there will be two here, because these two is governing both OH and NA. So I'm supposed to put two here, because these two governs everything. So, because they have 2, 2, 2, 2, it means I'm allowed to rule out such that I'll be left with H plus, plus OH minus, to give me H2O. So, correct. I'll take another neutralization. All the neutralization reactions, we end up having this ionic equation. Even when I change the acid and change the base, as you see now, I'll still arrive at this. That's why you can define neutralization as the reaction between hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion to form water. That is neutralization for you. Because the work of this acid is to donate the hydrogen ion, while the base is to produce the hydroxyl ion. Let me change the acid and base and write the ionic equation. We will still arrive here. Instead of H2O4, let me use HNO3. Yes. Let's use HNO3 plus, instead of sodium hydroxide, let me use potassium hydroxide. Remember, the product of a neutralization is salt and water, and the salt is when this metal takes over, it becomes KNO3 plus H2O. Now, try to remember what I told you. What you do in ionic equation is write out the, I'm expanding, the ionic equation is H plus, is only one, so I won't put two, unlike here, because there is two here, that's why I added two. Then plus NO3, remember what I told you, NO3, Cl, and OH all have minus one. Get that? Then plus K. Remember your NaC. I've cleaned it. NaC, NaHK. All of them have plus. But the equation is balanced. Please, I skipped it. State of matter, very necessary, very very important. And this is liquid. H plus
NO3 minus plus K plus then plus OH minus to give me K plus plus NO3 minus plus H2O. Remember, I don't have to say what I repeat it exactly. What next? Pick ions that are similar and equal in number and cancel out. This is NO3. It's only one. There's an NO3 here. Cancel, cancel. This is potassium ion. This is also potassium ion. So they have gone. So we are left with only what? H plus plus OH minus to give us H2O. You see that we have arrived at this place again. So this is the ionic equation for every neutralization reaction. So from ionic equations, you can see two reactions that have different reactants, but they are undergoing the same type of a reaction. That is it for neutralization. Let's go higher in redox, writing ionic equation of some redox reactions, because sometimes this is where students might find it difficult in writing ionic equation. But I think I will check the one that have a solid, because I've been using aqueous liquid. Let me try another one that have a solid reactant. I think this is good to go. Yeah. Okay, let us see reaction of a calcium trioxocarbonate 4 with HCl to give us definitely calcium chloride. This is aqueous. This is solid. Then plus, anytime an acid reacts with a trioxocarbonate 4, there will be liberation of carbon 4 oxide, which turns lime water milky. That's CO2. So let's balance the equation first before going to the ionic equation. The molecular equation must be balanced before you can derive ionic equation from it. So what do we do? Chlorine here is 2, is 1 here. Watch my video on how to balance chemical equations, please. So we have 2, we have 1, so we do 2 here. And when we put 2 here, hydrogen is already 2. I think these 2 are settled the whole thing. And this is aqueous, liquid, and now finally gas. Yes, I love this. We have solid, we have all the possible states of matter here. Solid, liquid, gas, then aqueous. So what do we do? The ionic equation is CaCO3, because it is solid, my dear, repeat it. CaCO3. S, don't dissociate it, because if it doesn't dissolve in water, it cannot be dissociated. So what does it mean now? Plus, this is our H, 2H plus. Remember the hydrogen is plus 1. Then, plus 2Cl minus. Why am I putting it? Because these two governs everything here. To give me Ca2 plus calcium, remember, become or group 2 elements. Calcium is among the group 2, they all have plus 2. Then plus, remember this is chlorine, say 2Cl minus, because it's 2 in number. Then plus, this is water. The rule says don't dissociate anything that is not aqueous in right ionic equation. And this is now gas. You repeat it exactly the way it is. And remember, if you write ionic equations properly, the charges and everything will be balanced. The number of charges, the net charge must be equal on both sides. I'll show you after this.
Hi, my name is Cheryl, and I'm Jennifer. Guess what? There's a channel called Her Majesty Easy World Science.
And you know the best part? To make science so easy. Wow.
It makes science easy, simplified, and very, very fun.
Guess what? Rocky science ain't rocky science anymore.
It's now ABC.
Like if you need science in your entire life.
Another thing about Her Majesty Easy World Science Channel is that he makes available laboratory equipment and reagents.
Guess the best part? If chemistry has been hard for you, he does tutorials.
And another thing is, when you order for these things, they are high quality and they are also cheap and affordable.
If you want to order, just look at the number on the screen.
And don't forget to subscribe and hit the little notification button down below.
Don't forget to share, of course. Obviously, there's love in sharing.
Thank you. We'll see you there.
Next step is to find species that are alike and cancel out. Then allow the only one that is different to remain. Anyone without a similar thing on the other side should remain. CaCO3, do you have anything CaCO3 here? No. So CaCO3 survives. Then here, plus H plus, do you have any H plus here? There is no H plus. So 2H plus survives. Then plus 2Cl minus. Do you have such? Yes. 2Cl, 2Cl, so it cancels out. There's no more part of it. So the only surviving species on the reactant side is the calcium carbonate and the hydrogen ion. So we'll give you now what? Calcium ion plus water plus CO2. So this is the ionic equation of this equation. Now, to check if you are correct, atoms must be balanced and charges must be balanced. Watch me. Is there any charge here? Zero. I'm calculating the net charge on the reactant side. So there is no charge here, so I have zero. Is there any charge here? Yes. Plus 1 times 2. So 0 plus 1, that is, plus 1 times 2 is plus 2. So 0 plus 2 is plus 2. So on the reactant side, I have a charge of plus 2. So let's come to the product side. This is calcium 2 plus. So the charge here is 2 plus times 1 is the only one. So we have plus 2. No charges here. Plus 0, plus 0. Find out that the total charge here is 2. The total charge here is also 2. So in ionic equation, when you balance it well, the charges will be balanced. The number of charges on the reactant side must be equal to the number of charges on the product side. The atoms must also balance. Watch it. How many calcium do we have there? One atom of calcium. There is one atom of calcium. How many oxygen atoms? Three. Watch it. One plus two. Three. How many carbon atoms here? One carbon. And look at one carbon. How many hydrogen? Hydrogen atom is two. And there is two hydrogen here. So that settles the case. Okay? Then, let's go to ionic equation of more complex equations. We are taking a step higher now. Or rather, let me give you another one. Let's say sodium triazole carbonate 4 reacting with HNO3 to give us NaNO3 plus, there should be water, there should be CO2. Remember, whenever acid reacts with triazole carbonate 4, whenever acid reacts with any triazole carbonate 4, there will be formation of water and carbon dioxide. Unlike that first one I wrote, sodium carbonate, unfortunately, is aqueous. It dissolves. It's a soluble triazole carbonate 4. Remember, all sorts of sodium are soluble in water. And most triazole carbonates are insoluble in water, except that of sodium, potassium, and ammonium. They dissolve. But when you remove these ones I've mentioned, any other thing that is a carbonate, they are generally insoluble. Like magnesium carbonate, even if you have not seen it before, is insoluble. Calcium carbonate is insoluble. Beryllium carbonate is insoluble. Apart from that of sodium, potassium, and ammonium. I don't know if that of lithium might dissolve. Because of diagonal relationship, lithium have more similar properties to magnesium. You stay subscribed or you check my video on the periodic table to understand what I mean by diagonal relationship. Okay, which means sodium and potassium are in group 1. So the triazole carbonate 4 of group 1 dissolves in water. But other triazole carbonates do not dissolve. So don't be surprised if lithium carbonate do not dissolve because of diagonal relationship. Okay, that's just by the way. Let's balance this molecular equation before deriving the ionic equation. Sodium here is 1, here is 2. So we come here and do justice to sodium. Put 2 there. The hydrogen here is 1. Hydrogen here is 2. So we do justice to this and put 2. With this, remember, this acid can only exist in aqueous form. This one is still liquid. Water is liquid. Either liquid, solid, or gas. Water can never be aqueous. Okay? Now, writing the ionic equation, what do you have here? This is aqueous. You write 2Na plus plus CO3. Remember this. SO4, SO3, CO3 are all having minus 2. So I'll say 2 minus. Then, even if it's confusing you, is there any charge here? No charge, there is zero charge. If this is 2 plus, it means that this will be minus 2. So that 2 minus 2 will give me that zero. So now we have plus 2H plus, because of these two here, then plus 2, the same 2, NO3 minus. Remember NO3, chloride ion and hydroxy all have minus 1. So give me, let me continue from this side, to give me 2Na plus, then plus 2NO3 minus, plus water, repeat water, don't dissociate it, plus CO2. You got that? Okay? So, with this, you can now follow the next step. Cancel ions that are equal and similar. This is 2Na plus, cancel. 2Na plus, cancel. We have CO3, 2 minus. We don't have it, so it survives. plus, do you have hydrogen ion on both sides? No, it's only one. Then, next is 2NO3. Do you have it the other side? Yes, 2NO3. So what survives are only water and CO2. So this is the ionic equation. Remember, this is aqueous, this is also aqueous. This still remains liquid and this remains gas. So this is the ionic equation of this particular reaction. Check the charges. We have minus 2 here, then we have 2 times 1 plus 2, which means the net charge here is equal to 0. Is there any charge here? No, that's 0 plus 0. So you see it's correct. So charges must be equal in ionic equation. So how many atoms? Check if atoms are balanced. Carbon is 1. Oxygen is 3. Oxygen is 1 plus 2, 3. Hydrogen is 2. Hydrogen is 2. So that is it for this. Okay, let me now face a redox reaction and the ionic equation. Let's say we have K2, okay, yeah, the equation I used in balancing chemical equation, maybe let's try that one. K2Cr2O7 plus in acidic medium plus H2S to give me potassium tetraoxosulfate 6 plus chromium 3 tetraoxosulfate 6. Plus water, plus sulfur, because after teaching balancing the chemical equation, I followed this particular topic also. So we have done this equation there, so the coefficients are still fresh on my mind. This should be 7, and this should be 3. Yes. Now, if you are told to write the ionic equation, remember this is the molecular equation. We are now looking for the ionic equation. This is aqueous, state of matter, aqueous. This is gas. Hydrogen sulfide is a gas that has the smell of a rotten egg. Check my video here where I produce this particular gas using Kipps apparatus and the chemical properties. So here is also aqueous. Here is also aqueous. Here is liquid. Then sulfur is solid. Is it soluble? The rule says dissociate only the ones in aqueous state. That is those ones that are soluble in water. Okay? So what we do here, we have that this is potassium and it's 2. 2K plus, then this as a group, this is a compound ion, is a radical, which means Cr2O7. You can even calculate to know the charge that will be present actually. This is chromium 6, so 6 times 2 is 12. But oxygen is minus 2, that's the addition of oxygen. So minus 2 times 7 is 14, but this is chromium 6. 6 times 3 is 12. So 12 minus 14 is minus 2. So what will be here is 2 minus. So I'm telling you all around what you can use. If you don't remember, if you have 2 plus, you will be looking for 2 minus. So that it will sum up to the 0 that is here. Then we move on. Remember, I'm deriving the ionic equation. We come here. This is the acid. It's aqueous. So I have to balance. Watch this. How many hydrogen atoms are here? 8 hydrogen atoms. So I will first write it 8. That's 2 times 4. H plus, then plus, remember this 4 governs everything inside, so I have 4SO42-. Remember, SO42 must have 2 minus. Well, this 4 is due to this 4 here. Then plus, this is hydrogen sulfide. You repeat it exactly. Aqueous compounds. Compounds that dissolve in water. Then we come to the product side. What do we have first? 2K plus. Then plus SO42-, then plus, this is chromium 3. For this compound to exist, this must have 3 as oxidation number. Remember, SO4 as a group have minus 2, so this thing in bracket is minus 2. So minus 2 times 3 is minus 6. If you have minus 6, you must provide plus 6, and that is why the chromium is providing 6, and there are 2 providing 6, which means 1 out of the 2 provides plus 3. Watch my video on short course on how to calculate oxidation number in chemistry, you understand what I mean. But if you are sharp, you understand what I explained just now. So, chromium 3, which means we will now write 2Cr3+. Simple. Then, remember SO4 here, they are 3 in number. They are radical, but they are 3 as a group. So, plus 3SO42-, plus what? What do I do here? Do I dissociate it into OH and H plus? Don't be tempted. Don't dissociate water. Just write 7H2O liquid. Then plus 3S solid. It cannot be ions. Then, this shows that only strong electrolytes are dissociated because water is a weak electrolyte. Now, the next rule says cancel ions that are alike. When you find ions that are alike on both sides, they should cancel each other. First, serially, this is potassium ion. Do you have another potassium ion? Yes, and they are all equal, which means I rule off this. Cancel. Cancel. Next one is Cr2O72- on the reactant side. Check if you have it on the product side. Check well. We don't have anything like that, which means it survives. Whenever you are man alone, you survive. Whenever you are man alone, you survive. But when you have a similar thing, you kill each other. Plus, do you have hydrogen ion on this side? We don't have hydrogen ion, so which means this one survives. Then, 4SO42-, we have SO42- on both sides, but here we have one of it. This is one group, then we have three. So you see that 1 + 3 is still 4, so which means all SO4 goes out of it because they are equal in number on both sides. Then what next? We have hydrogen sulfide on both sides, we don't have. So hydrogen sulfide survives. So to give us, the only thing I did not cancel here is 2Cr3+ plus 7H2O plus 3S. Now check if the equation is balanced. Check if the atoms are balanced and equally the ions are balanced. First, what do you do? This is minus 2. I'm checking the charges now. This is minus 2. That's the charge. Minus 2 plus 8. Because this is 8 times 1 plus 8. So we have total of what? Plus 6. Minus 2 plus 8 is plus 6. Then let's check here. 2 times 3 is 6. So we have, this is 0, this is 0. So charges are correct. So there are equal number of charges on both sides. So here is plus 6 and here is also plus 6. Then check the number of atoms. How many oxygen do we have here? We have 7 oxygen. That is 7 oxygen also. How many hydrogens do we have here in total? This is 8 hydrogen plus 6. 2 times 3, 14. Then we have 2 times 7, 14. How many sulfur? 3. We have 3 here. So this is a correct ionic equation of this long or big equation. Now, if in exam, if they give you balancing of equation or whether ionic or molecular equation in objective questions, if they call here X, call here Y, call here Z, my dear, don't solve it. Just use their options and start testing it. Maybe they say A is 4 or let's say 2, 3, 4. Then B says 1, 4, 5. C says something like this, just 2, 2, 1. D says 4, 4, 2. Well, just pick this. If they call here X, call here Y, call here Z, use 2 here, 3 here for you, and now check if they balance. If they don't balance, they try this one. So it will save you time using the option to try than going to balance it by yourself. You might get what? At a stage, you might be thrown off balance. Now, I will also use this particular topic, balancing ionic equations, and teach you, because while writing it, you're also balancing it. Sometimes in exam, especially redox, let me now focus it more now on writing redox equations. Remember, redox equations are clearly understood from their ionic equation. If you write the ionic equation, you will understand it very, very well. Like, this is a redox reaction. Where this is the oxidizing agent and here is the reducing agent. How do we know? If you come here, chromium here is plus 6. But on coming down here, chromium now becomes plus 3. So ionic equation will prove to you the species that is reduced and the species that is oxidized. Plus 6 is here and here we are seeing plus 3. It means that this Cr2O7 has been reduced. But if you check here now, sulfur here is actually minus 2, but here is now 0. It
means that sulfur has been oxidized. Even without understanding the charge, removal of hydrogen is oxidation. So when you change H2S to S, it is called oxidation. Why? You have removed hydrogen. That means hydrogen sulfide is the reducing agent. The agent that is oxidized is the reducing agent. Then the agent that is reduced is the oxidizing agent. Now, in the balancing of ionic equation and writing it, I think I've settled that one. I've shown you what happens in neutralization reaction, and I also show you the ionic equation of the reaction between triazole carbonate and dilute acids, where I used one soluble triazole carbonate and the other one is soluble. I gave you the ionic equations. So I now also show redox reaction and the ionic equations. So let me still give you another displacement reaction and the ionic equation also, so that you can get acquainted with, get properly guided, because I'm here for you. You can't go any other place that is better than this channel. Please, I want you to stay close. Expand the easy world of science. Don't ever be an opaque object. Spread the light. There are two ways, actually, one can spread the light. It is either the candle producing the light, or you are the mirror reflecting it. Let's assume God has made me the candle that produces the light. My dear, can you be my mirror to reflect my light? Share this video. Let your friends know about this channel, the Easy World of Science. You can also visit my website, www.easyworldscience.com. I'm here for you. Your academic success is my topmost priority. Now, let me give you another molecular equation and the ionic equation in displacement reaction. Let us see zinc solid reacting with copper 2 tetraoxosulfate 6. This is aqueous. It will give me Cu in solid state plus zinc tetraoxosulfate 6. This is aqueous. So this is a solid metal you added into a solution of copper tetraoxosulfate 6. This is blue. This will be blue in the beginning. But at the end, after the whole reaction, the collective, this one will be brown, this one will now be colorless, just like water. Because it shows, the colorless shows that zinc ion is now present. But the blue shows that copper 2 ion is present. So the ionic equation is non dissociated solid, you repeat, plus. So what I'm trying to tell you is that if any reaction occurred in the same phase, and that phase, or in the same state, like if a reaction occurs all in solid state, there is no ionic equation for such reaction. So be careful now. Not every reaction will have ionic equation. Reactions that have gases throughout, there is no ionic equation. Reactions that have solids throughout or liquids throughout, there is no ionic equation. It is only when it is in aqueous form or a form of electrolyte dissolved in water. Then, here means, I told you it's blue because this is the ion causing the blue color, plus SO42 minus will give me CuS. You don't, it's already solid, plus it is colorless because zinc 2 ion is colorless, plus SO42 minus. Cancel ions that are similar and equal. This is zinc, this is not even an ion. Copper 2 ion is here. Do we have copper 2 ion here? No. Copper 2 ion is not the same thing as copper metal, that is solid. So I will keep this. This one has survived. Cu2, that's zinc in solid state, plus Cu2 plus. Then SO42 minus, do we have it the other side? Yes, so it cancels out. So that what remains is CuS plus zinc 2 plus. So in this ionic equation, you already know that this must be aqueous. Anyone that is in ion is aqueous. So you have seen that this was solid. Now, got inside the solution as an ion, then displaced out copper. It means that zinc has displaced copper. Please, the reverse is impossible. Like the reverse, this reaction is not reversible. Copper cannot displace zinc. So God bless you so much. Remain majestic. Thank you.
Much love. Remain majestic.
I love you. Thank you for watching.